Hi viewers, welcome to Mirake the Tribe. My name is Ayushi and I'm from India. This is going to be for the end of May reading, so these readings are of course late because they were supposed to be for the entire month of May, but as it is, I don't have many subscribers who are, I guess, Leo right now, so I just took my liberty to come out with this video, which is for the Leos, because I was already burdened with a lot of private readings, and in my own personal life I was focused on different things, so I could not take out time. And I also feel that Leos are going through some heavy energies, and not right now. I think you are dealing with heavy energies since last year August or sometimes then. If there is a lot of noise that you can hear, then kindly ignore it if you can. And if you are waiting for your personal reading, if some of you are waiting for your readings, they are coming. I am a little bit behind schedule, so kindly bear with me. What are the energies coming in for Leo's Sun, Moon, Rising for the end of May messages moving into June? I think your cards are ready. I'll shuffle two more times. Messages for Leo's Sun, Moon, Rising moving into June. What are the messages for Leo's for the month of May, ending May, moving into June? Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising. What are the messages? Okay. So there is someone either you are traveling or your partner is traveling, or you are in a long distance and there is back and forth communication with this person. There is some transformation that you are going through. You can be in a foreign land right now. You want another major arcana, the Fool, so you want to start afresh because you have been, like, something has died, like there has been a transformation with a Scorpio or a Aries. So you went through some transformation and you have to start afresh. Look at these two birds. One is done, like it's so dead, it's like it can't fly anymore, it's dead, it's all bones and skeleton. While this is a newborn chick, so you are ending something and starting something new. You're trusting your gut instincts. Here you are trusting your divine, your surrounding, the universe. You're trusting yourself. You're willing to take that leap of faith. You're willing to start afresh. You're also trusting your intuition because you feel your intuition is quite strong. Or if you don't feel like that, then you should know that you can trust your intuition. You have High Priestess coming. And you could also be dealing with a Pisces. So you have a message, like a passionate message for someone, someone in long distance. I think there has been a heartbreak for some of you, like a loss. You are grieving that loss, and you are coming out of that loss actually, because you have realized that things have ended. You either have choice between two people, or you are dealing with a Gemini, or you have to decide if you want to have a partnership with this person that you are dealing with. Do you want them in your life or not? You are also moving away from a troubled waters to a calmer place. You are moving to your rainbow, leaving the darkness behind. I also feel that you are very, very enthusiastic about something. What has happened to my voice? I've been doing readings, so it has affected my voice also. So you feel enthusiastic, or you feel that either you feel very enthusiastic or you are not that enthusiastic, so you are looking elsewhere where you can find something worth putting in time and energy in, because you want to leave the current situation. Like, you feel that it's not emotionally fulfilling. Messages for Leo, Sun, Moon, and Rising. 10 card Celtic cross, messages for Leo sun moon rising, end of May, beginning of June. Bottom of the deck, you are trying to work things out, you are trying to work with people, or you are just trying to be a team player. You are trying to be, by the way, my top says power to the women. I really like this top. I just felt like sharing. Center of this reading is that you are feeling stuck. You feel that you cannot liberate yourself from a situation which has been holding you down. You feel that you are stuck in a situation where there is no growth, no moving forward. You are also tied down in your own thoughts, like you are emphasizing on certain thoughts and something of that sort, like you have thoughts which are not serving you. You have thoughts which are not helping you grow. So yes, and what's challenging you is that Mother of Pentacles. So it can be Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn person which is challenging you, or it can be your partner. This person is probably not feeling very like they don't want to nourish it you anymore, or you don't want to nourish them, something of that sort. This is coming up as a challenge. So either you are not even nourishing your own self, so that is coming up. Bottom of this reading is the sun card. So I feel that there is a reason to be happy about. There is something that has come to light. There has been some clarity over a situation. There could be something also related to someone getting pregnant, and I can also feel that some people did not want this child or something of that sort. Something related to child definitely for some of you is here. Son of Cups in the past. So something related to someone being very emotional, someone being in their feelings, someone who wears their hearts in their sleeves, someone very, very creative and very naive, very innocent, someone like a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, someone young, someone a little bit open with their feelings, open with their heart. You were dealing with someone like that, or you were like this in the past. What's crowning you is the Three of Swords. I feel here that you feel that either there is a three-party situation between you, your partner, and the child, or you feel that this coming of a child has disrupted something, or there is a third person which is disrupting something, or there is someone who is just busy at workplace, or some like a third scenario is affecting the relationship. That is what I'm getting here. Someone had expressed their emotion of love in the past. In future, though, you do have happiness, you have completion, and you will feel emotionally balanced and satisfied, and you will feel secure, you will feel abundant, you will feel emotionally fulfilled. So don't give up, because you have two very, very beautiful cards here coming up. So I think you are just having this hurt feeling from past, something that you are not able to let go. So you need to focus and divert your attention. You need to focus on your healing. Here is your how you come up in your reading. So you are coming up as the Empress, which is really, really great. Like, so you have really nice cards here. So you are feeling very creative. You have a lot of resources. You can invest in yourself. You can start something new. You can invest in nurturing other person. Definitely someone is getting pregnant here. So guys, if you don't want that child, then because this is a reading of family, like I just see family here. So yes, so some of you are dealing with another Leo or a Taurus person. It can be sun, moon, rising. I also feel that after the, like, in last 2 days probably you are feeling much better. Even though you did feel like things were not moving forward, I think soon you will start to experience the shift. Someone has brought you some message. This person was stalking you, or you were stalking this person, but someone has been trying to communicate with you. Someone has been trying to they are trying to understand where you are, what you are doing. They want all that information in order to approach you, because they want to approach you in the right time. But a lot of immature energy, like in past you met someone and you want this person to come back. Like whoever this person was, it can be your child, like you are wishing for a child, or you had a child, or you just knew someone who was a little bit younger, or someone who expressed emotions towards you, and you I feel you are waiting for this person to come back. You hope for this person. Yes, that is what I'm getting here. Leo, this is your card again as the outcome. So I feel that by the end of this month, May, you are feeling very, very strong. You do have obstacles to overcome, because like I said, you have this two cards coming up. So to overcome a heartbreak that happened in the past, or that is still on your mind, you will have to have a lot of strength. You will have to have a lot of grace and courage to make it possible to get yourself out of that mental space where you feel that you were you were betrayed or something. And I'm also getting that in past someone expressed their emotion towards you. Right now you're feeling that you are feeling right now you're feeling stuck in your own thinking and thoughts. In future though, you are feeling much better. You have 10 of cups coming up. So I'll clarify a few cards here. And like I said, you are focused on your work, or you want to make something work, or this third party situation for some of you is coming from workplace, like someone was involved at workplace, but things are currently balanced. Like if you are working somewhere, you will get the returns, like however effort you, how much effort you will put, like the kind of effort that you will put, you will receive the similar kind of result. So yes, that is coming up, and you do have a lot of options. But I think right now you have to work from your logical side and not from your heart, work from your heart space. Don't leave your heart behind, because it's definitely very important to listen to your heart. If you're not listening to your heart, then it's not worth it. So don't get very logical and analytical about things. Always listen to your heart first. Now I will clarify a few cards here for you, Leo. I can't find my deck. Okay. This reading is for Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising. Kindly clarify this 10 card Celtic cross for the end of May, beginning of June, starting of June. Clarify this reading for the sign of Leo. What is this heartbreak about for Leo? What is this heartbreak about for Leo? What is holding them back? What is this heartbreak for Leo? Okay. Heartbreak is about the heartbreak. So yes, there was a three-party situation. Someone was using you, is what I'm getting. Someone was using you. I'm also getting that you had to, it could be another Leo, or you had to, you will need a lot of courage to deal with this situation, because it has really broken your heart. You will have to make a decision about this situation, like a decision in a way that, do you want to indulge with this person again? Because three of swords with two of swords is fight. So even if you will try to indulge with this person, I think you fear that you will get into a fight, and it will be an ego battle, and it has a lot of pride attached to it. There is a lot of competition around this, lots of fiery nature. So this person can be fiery as well. Like I said, it can be another fire sign, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries, this person is also fighting really hard, or you are fighting really hard for this person. Right now you are just fighting, and what is this Eight of Swords for you in the center? Some of you are not able to move forward from the situation which is holding you back. You need to pull back. Some of you need to pull back and also control your drinking, and if you are into all that, because I'm getting that you are quite indulgent. If you are drinking too much, to avoid this coping mechanism. For example, in a coping mechanism sort of way, it's not gonna work, and you need to understand that. Okay, I got all the three major arcanas, so I'm getting that this person has been dominating you, and they have been giving you a lot of work to do. They are not holding their end of the bargain. They are also quite very, they can be very harsh with their tongue. Can be an air sign, Libra, Aquarius, Gemini, Sun, Moon, Rising. This person can be at work and they don't give you enough time and energy, probably. That is coming up. You have to keep your patience. So you were keeping your patience, and now you're tired of keeping your patience with this person. They can be working in a company where they are, there are a lot of people working. I also feel that you are defending yourself against this person, like you really want to run away from this situation. You don't want to deal with this anymore because you feel very stuck. What is this Mother of Pentacles as a challenge? Yes, someone is having trouble coordinating their work life and love life, or they are just juggling two people. So I'm getting here that someone is someone has lack of passion, and they are not they are leaving somebody out in the cold. For some of you, your partner is staying away from you. Yes, there is no stability in this situation. So you feel very unstable. You feel stuck. You feel that. Sorry about the train, guys. You feel that any moment this thing can come crashing down, and you will not be able to handle it. But I feel that you will soon have victory. If you will just be bold and courageous enough, your dreams can come true. If you can just focus on your dreams and take help from your friends, or just reach out to people, I think you will have some victory in the situation, because you do have the Sun card, so there will be some clarity, some joy, some happiness coming your way. Yes, as soon as you will liberate yourself from the situation, I think you will find someone who is understanding and caring, which is why you are probably getting the Sun card, which is a lot of happiness. In future also you have Ten of Cups. Either you will try to make your partner understand your point of view, and that's how you will come to a conclusion that okay, let's make it work, because this is making it work, like let's make it work. And then this is about, I will put only that much effort, I won't put more effort than the other person. So you are just holding yourself back and not putting too much effort. You are willing to wait it out, but it is making you sad. So if you are waiting, it's not gonna work. Like, you need to move on with your life. What is the Strength card as the outcome for Leo? Strength card as the outcome for Leo. I'm also getting that some of you have self-worth issues, like you don't love yourself enough, because that is why the Empress is in coming up as you, or this person has some thing. I think by the end of this month you are ending the cycle with this person, because you are you can be dealing with the Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, or Aquarius, Leo, Scorpio,
Scorpio, Leo,
Aquarius, Taurus. Yes, I said all that. Yes, I feel by the end of this month you are moving into June with lot of strength and grace. Lot of like you can fight it out. You are able to overcome the situation. You are also feeling financially. You are feeling very stable. Like you are feeling very stable and grounded. Here's the card. You can also be working on your money. I'm also getting you are ending a old cycle. Like either you are ending your own thought pattern, the way you used to think, the way you used to do things, or you are just ending this thing with this person. I'm also getting that luck is on your side. If you choose to end this entire thing, I think the luck is going to be on your side. You have to keep fighting though. Like you have to be very, very strong. You have to trust your instincts and keep working hard at it. Don't try to push anything. Don't try to force anything because that's not gonna work. I'm also getting Nine of Pentacles with the Judgment. So first you will have to become single. First you will have to lose them to get them back, if that is the case. Because the Judgment card is coming, so I'm getting that you will think about giving them a second chance. But before that, you just have to leave the situation so that the person that you're dealing with, they realize that what they have done, and then probably they will come back and they will ask for forgiveness. Or even if they don't, I think you have to just forgive them and move on, because not often do we get any apology from people who have hurt us, because they don't probably even realize that how their actions are affecting us. And I think yes, you are being very patient and starting something new in your career. You have Nine of Pentacles and King of Pentacles, so I do feel, and then this Ace of Pentacles as the bottom of the deck. So I'm getting that you are starting something new, some of you, like a new job, or you are just investing your time and money elsewhere, something new. It's not something that where you have had always put your energy. It's somewhere new you are putting your energy. Give me one card for the Leo Sun, Moon, Rising for May and May 2018. One animal totem card. What is one card for? So these are a lot of cards. So you have insect. You have the card insect. This is like a butterfly or something. Feminine power, spirituality and renewal. You are going through some transformation. You are also very spiritually connected, some of you right now. And you need to embrace your feminine power. Guys, I'm gonna just pull it again. Power to the women. Women are not like just one gender. There is a masculine and a feminine quality. Like women can be masculine as well and feminine. So, and a man can be a masculine and feminine as well. So they need to, everyone needs to integrate both these qualities in themselves. So try to come from your feminine quality. I guess that some, like you, either you are being dominating, like dominant, or someone like your partner is being dominant. So someone needs to be a little bit feminine, or they need to, like you came up as an empress. So you do have a lot to offer, but I think you need to direct that to your own self, like for your own benefit. If you are giving it to other people and not doing the same thing for yourself, I don't think that is healthy way to go about it. I also will pull out a what is the blockage for the sign of Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising. There is a completion for some of you, like something has ended definitely. You need to learn to how to expand from here, like how, where to go from here. You were dealing with someone who was being impartial to you, someone who was not treating you properly, someone who was being dominant, and you were being despondent. You were losing faith and hope in the situation. So these are your blockages. You are not able to move forward, but the bottom of the deck here is the growth. You have to propel yourself to move towards something new, something that will make you grow into a new person. So start something new, Leo. Don't keep hanging on to this person. Start something new. All right. Now, that was your May reading. I don't know if I am going to post the June videos. Right now, I don't think I am going to post because I have a certain commitments that I have to take care of. So let's see. I'll see you again.